Hello, and thank you for joining us. As your organization moves toward the private cloud, you will need a more cost-effective and flexible approach for turning your heterogeneous infrastructure components into a private cloud. This means having the ability to abstract your diverse infrastructure into logical resources, create a cloud, and then delegate resources to users who need them to deploy services. The Virtual Machine Manager component of Microsoft System Center 2012 lets you see the virtualization infrastructure that has already been deployed with virtual machines or services. And it allows you to manage the underlying physical components. Plus, you gain the ability to manage underlying compute, network, and storage resources. If demand changes, you can simply add the resources you need, whether they are in Windows Server Hyper-V clusters, Citrix Xen Server clusters, or VMware vSphere clusters. Heterogeneous environments are also supported by Virtual Machine Manager. Now let's deploy a bare metal physical computer operating system with System Center 2012. We'll use Virtual Machine Manager to connect to the machine via the baseboard management controller. First, we'll install the operating system and hypervisor on the machine, and then we'll add it as an additional resource to our cloud. You can do this in Virtual Machine Manager by simply choosing the login account for the baseboard management controller, and then choosing the protocol that you want to use for deploying that operating system. Let's go ahead and choose the IP range of the machines we will scan to find a suitable host to deploy this operating system to. Searching the different IP addresses within that range and connecting to the baseboard management controller over the protocol we selected reveals a number of hosts that we can deploy a new operating system to. Let's pick this server and step through the rest of the wizard. The wizard installs the operating system and allows us to choose the host group, as well as the configuration of the deployed operating system through the host profile. By creating a host profile, you can easily and repeatedly deploy the same operating system image to many different hosts. We need to give the host a name. Let's click OK to start the deployment process for that host. As you can see, the job has begun and we are in the process of deploying the operating system to the host. With these new host resources available, we can now abstract the physical resources and create a cloud. A cloud within Virtual Machine Manager is a virtual abstraction of physical resources, which can include dedicated or shared resources. Let's create this abstraction by going to the VMs and Services workspace and then clicking Create Cloud. After giving the cloud a name, we can choose which resources to allocate to this cloud. Let's pick the Administrative Infrastructure Host Group, which provides access to all of the different servers and clusters already deployed inside that host group, whether they are Microsoft, VMware, or Citrix hypervisors. Then let's choose the different logical networks that are available to this cloud, along with load balancers. You can select among the different types of storage that may be available. Selecting the specific classification of storage helps ensure that the different virtual machines will be deployed upon storage with the appropriate performance and reliability. You can even set limits on the resources this cloud can consume, including limits on memory, storage, or processors. Let's assign this cloud 64 gigabytes of RAM, as well as limit the number of virtual machines. The last thing to specify is the type of virtual machines available for this cloud to use. Here we have only Hyper-V hosts deployed in this host group, so let's just choose Hyper-V. At this point, we have created a new cloud called Infrastructure, and that cloud has access to the resources we specified. Now we need to delegate access to the individual users who will be using this cloud. Let's create a user role for self-service users so they can deploy new cloud services, whether they want to deploy simple virtual machines or a complete service. Let's call this group Infrastructure Admins. They will have access, as self-service users, to just this particular cloud that we created. Finally, let's assign the members of this group via Active Directory to a domain group called Cloud Users. Let's choose the cloud we just created as the scope, allowing these users to see just that cloud and no other ones. Next, let's specify the kind of access and quantity of resources these users can allocate within this cloud. For quota, you can specify not only at the per-user level, but at the group level as well. For example, you may want the entire group to be limited to 10 gigabytes of RAM and 40 virtual machines. You may have other groups accessing this cloud, and may not want this one set of users to monopolize the cloud's resources. At this point, we have specified that each individual member can only create 4 virtual machines, even though the sum total for the entire group is 40, which means that we can have up to 10 users running 4 virtual machines. If any user tries to add a 41st virtual machine, it won't be created. You can also specify the particular resources users can access. This gives you control over the different virtual machines and different services that these users can deploy. Let's give these users access to both the customer demographics and the 3-tier staging service templates, which consist of templates for a collection of virtual machines. Finally, let's assign the particular actions these users can perform within this cloud. And let's assume we want to maintain control over the types of virtual machines these users can deploy, and then allow them to deploy virtual machines from a template only. We can give them the ability to pause and resume, connect to these virtual machines, delete them, save them, and start them and shut them down, but we will not give them the ability to create their own virtual machines from scratch. Now that we have created these virtual machine environments, our users can log in as their user role and start deploying virtual machines to this one particular cloud that we have given them access to. To recap, you saw how easy it is to manage your diverse compute, storage, and network resources, and then bring them all together to create a cloud environment. You have also seen how to delegate access of cloud resources to the users that need them. Ultimately, you can save time and effort in deploying, creating, and even delegating access while allowing self-service users to more quickly and easily access cloud resources. Thank you for watching this video on the Virtual Machine Manager capabilities of System Center 2012. We encourage you to take full advantage of these capabilities as you deliver your private cloud.